Hello, my friends. I kinda chose a really interesting and unusual way to drive this car because I chose one of the quite slow car, slow tracks for very fast F1 car. Now, if I'm not mistaken, this is a car which was driven by Niki Lauda, and as you can see, it just looks absolutely, I don't know, amazing. It's just a monster, and it is very thrilling to drive this car, even in a racing simulator, and we're just gonna go for it. So this is a Ferrari T something like that, 300 and something, I'm not really sure, and I don't really care, because I know that this car was driven by Niki Lauda, and I know it has more than 400 horsepower, and it is very lightweight. It is less than 700 kilos. The acceleration is just amazing. Look at this man. Oh my god. I was just driving Audi S1 at this track. And now I'm driving. Okay, now we get to why there were so many accidents in old F1s. Because I don't know, this car is very tricky to drive. It has lots of grip, but if you lose it, then you're just done.
About this, and I even watch Grand Tour, and sometimes
something informative and interesting. Probably something compares to that, but it's definitely still a very, very good sounding car. There is no denying about that. Or they're there and they do it, just push it and maybe go for the hot lap. Or stare there, but we're okay. Okay, please turn the car. I think I should have probably taken the first gear there, but it's okay. Great. Drift. Power. Great. Second gear. Go. Gear lead. And... oh, damn. So in the dirty in terms of oh wow, did you see that? Okay, I think it was enough for today. I really said everything what I really liked about this car and what I really wanted to say, so I think it's definitely enough. And yeah, compared to like newer F1 cars, it is just not as good, and there is quite a big of gap, but it does not really matter, because as I said, this car has really, really rawness in it, and it just feels so, so nice to drive. Even on a racing simulator, you can feel it. Alright, let's break, and bye-bye.